lying down beside you, what's going through your head?
Oh, today we're starting off with just a regular chef's knife, garlic for mincing. We have an apple to show you a corn technique. And then I have two hacks for you. So we're going to start off with knife cuts, and this is basically to show you how you should be holding a knife and how it's going to be safer for you when you chop, so you don't chop a finger off, you don't cut skin, nothing. So a lot of people, they feel comfortable with this finger. Never place that finger there because it can always slip or anything and everything will just be a mess. Right here is kind of like a safety grip. It's safe to put it here. And you should feel more secure when chopping. It's just if you're going through something more tough or something that is not so easy to go through. So this is another one where you just hold the back of the handle, as I'm going to show you here, and just go in a circular motion kind of and chop. Next, I'm going to show you the safety grip, where you hold the side, but your majority of your hand is still on the handle. You never want any of your fingers on the actual blade, and just chops very easily, and ta-da, we cut a tomato. This is the apple coring technique. So basically you want to imagine the pit in the center that you don't want to eat. So you cut all four sides that are around the pit, and you have your apple slices, and you can chop it from there if you want it for a snack. But there's the pit right there, throw it out. On to mincing. So basically you're going to do a rough chop, and here I'm showing you, do not place your fingers near the blade. You always want them to be away, so just watch for your fingers. I'm gonna do a rough chop here.
We're a thousand miles from comfort. We have traveled land and sea.
And then from here, what you're gonna do is you're gonna take your slices that you just cut, and you're gonna do a motion that is about 180, half a circle, and you just go back and forth like I'm going to be doing, and you just see how it gets smaller and smaller as you chop. And this is to make sure that all your pieces are even and there's no big pieces, it's all minced. Now, your first hack that I have for you is, one recipe calls for egg white only or a yolk only. Well, don't do what I just did, but you can separate it this way so you don't have to use any tools or anything fancy. You have either the yolk for your recipe or the egg white. My second hack is for ice cream or sherbet or anything. I have a sherbet here. It was in the freezer. I couldn't get into it, so I have hot water. And you just want to dip your ice cream scooper or spoon in there for just a couple of seconds, and it just softens it right up, and you're able to scoop as much as you need. And those are my hacks today. I hope you enjoy.